So good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sharmee Divan. I am a coach, I am a batch flower therapist, I am an angel therapist, and I do many other healing modalities as well. I have been in this field for about 15 plus years now, and I just keep learning, exploring. As I grow, my modalities grow, my clients grow, and this is something that I'm very passionate about. I enjoy doing this work. It's the joy that brings me here and everywhere else that I go over and over again. And I am starting the talk at Health Library in the year 2020, I thought, why not talk about the much rave New Year resolutions, right? And a lot of us do make resolutions. Do you understand the meaning of a resolution?
Yes.
What does it mean?
It's like goals, writing goals and timetable, everything, like planning for the whole year.
Yeah, exactly. And do we stick to them?
Definitely. Sometimes we stick, sometimes it slip.
Exactly. So today I'm here to talk about resolution versus commitment. And I actually researched this on the net. I looked up the dictionary, and it's very funny because two different places gave me the same meaning of a resolution and a commitment, which is a firm decision to do or not to do something. Now, two different sites at two different points gave me this same definition of a resolution as well as a commitment. Another one that I got to know, so of a resolution is a promise to yourself to do or not to do something. So promise that you make yourself. But what do we know about promises really? Promises are meant to be broken. Exactly. And especially a promise to yourself, I have my doubts about keeping. Whereas a commitment is a firm decision to do something, that I'm committing to something, right? Some of the synonyms that I found for resolution are intention. So I have an intention to do something. But when I say that I have the intention to do something, do I really do it? The big question comes over there. You know, I intend to do something. Exactly. So it's kind of like this, you know, try and hold this card. Try and hold it. No, try. I didn't say hold it. You know, so it is that. So it is, you know, the intention that puts you in tension, and then you don't do it. That is a resolution. You will follow it for the first three, if you are lucky enough, then maybe 7 or 10 days, and then it wears off. Now, why does this wear off? Let's look at understanding why a resolution wears off. Now, when you think of a resolution, you know, like aise sochte ki kuch tagda karna hai. Okay, so let's say that my New Year's resolution is to weigh 50 kilos, for example, right? So it's a big resolution to like reduce more than 25 kilos of what I am weighing. Just the massivity of it, the enormity of it is going to overwhelm me, and I will probably go to the gym on day one. Like, yes, karna hai, took the gym membership. This is the time that gyms make their best sales, right? Yeah, everybody rushes to the gym. Gyms have these offers, and people start gun ho, ekdam, aaj to bas, matlab, bhangi na ku, todi na ku, bhuko kari na ku. You know, like, I just want to do it. And they are committed, and they are on this diet, and GM diet, and PM diet, and God knows how many diets. Okay, and I am guilty. I have done this. I used to do this in my teens, and probably even after that. But if I am thinking of a resolution, it is something which is, it has to be big. The problem with it is that it has to be big. You know, it cannot be something like, oh, you know, I wake up at 7 a.m. in the morning, my resolution is to wake up at 6:50 in the morning, 5:00, right? That is like a 10-minute increment sort of a thing. So, but they will say, nahin, nahin, yaar, roz toh main 10 baje uthta hun, kal se na main roz 7 baje uthunga. Do you think they are going to stick to it? If you are waking up at 10 o'clock in the morning, how are you going to wake up at 7 o'clock from the very next day for the rest of your life? It's not possible. But let's say, so this is where I feel personally that a resolution fails. Because we make it larger than life. We make it something that it shouldn't be. And it is always in the beginning of the year. This is the most abused word of the new year and every single new year. Which is where I realized that, you know what? I have done this. I'm sure that you guys have done this. And I'm sure that the viewers who are going to watch this have done this. So how do I get from a resolution to a commitment? Now, when you think of a resolution, just the word like, resolution, oh yes. It has that energy. It has that zing. And jitna upar urta hai na, wo phuski hoke niche bhi aa jata hai, you know. Whereas if you think about a commitment, I have a commitment. My commitment today was to come to the help library on time. So that, you know, it is favorable for you, it's favorable for me, it's favorable for everyone. I am committed to coming here. It's not my resolution, oh, every day at 3 o'clock, I'm going to show up at the health library. That's not going to happen. It's definitely not going to happen. So if I'm looking at resolution, it's larger than life. The problem with a resolution is that versus a commitment. Now, and also what I would say about a resolution is because we are making it so big. So for example, like I said, you know, losing 25 kilos in the next 3 months. Is it possible? Yes. Can I do it? Yes. Should I do it? No. It's a very unhealthy thing to do, number one. And number two, it is very, very impractical, right? It's very impractical. Of course, if I'm 25 kilos down, I'm underweight. That's one thing. But 25 kilos versus giving myself a 5 kg increment, or here it would be decrement. So I'm going to lose 5 kilos in the next 5 months. Is this possible? It is possible. It is possible. It is realistic. It is time bound. If we think about the whole SMART goals thing, do we know about SMART goals? SMART goals. So what is the S for? Specific. M for? Measurable. A for? Achievable. R for? Realistic. Realistic. It is very realistic, like 1 kg a month, oh yeah, totally possible. 20 kgs a month is not possible only na, to matlab jis raaste ja nahi sakte uska naam kyun le rahe ho bhaiya, 3 din jao gym fir bye bye tata see you. Now be on that strict diet, 4th day indulge in a pizza. So how is it possible to then keep that resolution? So instead of a resolution, let's look at committing ourselves. Let's look at taking baby steps. If I was to think about commitment versus resolution, resolution is the destination. You are vested in the final outcome, which in return makes you lose the zing of enjoying the journey. I had a spine surgery back in 2016, December of 2016. And once I had it, of course, you know, I had to keep myself very healthy after that. And the doctor said that your entire health is going to depend on the way you take care of your spine. And I was about 15, 17 kilos more than what I am today. And it was close to the new year, so I was very tempted to resolute But what I instead did was that the moment the doctor says you can work out, I am going to commit to myself. It's a promise I am making myself that I commit to my body for it to be healthy. Weight loss will then become a byproduct of it. But I was not vested in the weight loss. I was more vested in, okay, so if I can like bend this much, tomorrow I'm going to try bending that much. And the next day I'm going to try bending that much. So it was a very baby step sort of an approach. And as I went along in that journey, I realized how much of this journey I have completely lost out on over so many years of me trying to lose weight. And I was literally almost only trying to lose weight because everybody said, because I thought, my parents thought, my relatives thought, everybody had a point of view about it. And I bought it. And that's what happens when we make resolutions also. Hey, tera resolution kya hai? Tera new year resolution kya hai? Tujhe kya lagta hai? Mera resolution kya hona chahiye? We're asking around. What is it that I want that I can commit myself to? When you get married to someone, it is a commitment that you make to somebody, right? And also to yourself to then be loyal to that partner. It is almost like that. A commitment stays for a very long time, perhaps even a lifetime. So for me, working out now is not even a thought that occurs. It's a natural thing for me to do because I committed myself to a good health, to my own well-being. Not because somebody else wanted it, but because I wanted it. I wanted to stand straight with a good posture in front of people and talk. It's what I do for a living. This is my work. So if I was not committed to my work, I would not be able to commit to my health and vice versa, right? So if we think about commitment, we're looking at it as a journey. And you know, you can always change, make minimum changes in this commitment and still stick to it. Let me give you an example here. Can you give me an example here of a commitment that if you know, keep, you go on with it and you also have the choice to change. With a resolution, no, what happens is that
committed to go on time to an appointment or whatever.
Yeah. Yeah, but like, let's say that you have a long-term goal. Let's look at a long-term goal. Anybody wants to share? You have a long-term goal that you want to achieve. You are a businessman. You might have one.
No, I've just brought the my visiting card of new company and I get the table. So I have a resolution that I can start manufacturing chemical within 2 years. That is like which chemical comes manufacturing, help to manufacture the sample.
Yeah.
Surfactant.
Hmm.
That is the liquid soap.
Huh. So if you have, so like, is that a resolution or a commitment that you're making to yourself?
It is a commitment.
It's a commitment that in 2 years you're going to go from like having no samples or not having the chemical to then having that chemical ready, yeah, right? And you have 2 years for it. So let's break that down, okay? If we were to break your commitment down, is it okay if I use your example?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So if we are using, what are you going to make? Chemical, right?
SLS.
SLS, okay. SLS.
E-S. After L-E. Both E-E. After L, just like E. After L.
Oh, SLES. Okay. Okay, that's a chemical. Yes, yes. And from not having it to having it, right? Now, let's break this two-year plan down. Okay, so you can probably make a schedule. So let's say that your first month, what are you going to do? What is your plan of action?
First month, I have to do come with the chemical engineer. I have a meeting appointed with him at Chiklur. So we have to sit and talk about the what are the machine and what are the expenditure and what are the total project cost.
So can we say the infrastructure?
Infrastructure, yeah.
Right, infrastructure. Okay, that is your first month, and then the second month, what are you going to do?
Second month, like setting up an office at Bombay.
Okay.
So I have an office, but I still I want a separate office for it.
Okay. So office space.
Office space.
Yeah.
And then. Third one, like appointing the salesman, marketing team.
So, PR?
I am making mistake, Abu. Not marketing.
No.
So, just arranging the working capital.
So, logistics.
Logistics.
Right.
Working so, capital. Logistic is a different part. It's not like
what about installations and all this thing?
So basically, like what I'm trying to say here is that there is a POA, there is a plan of action that he has in place. Now let's say that we are making this whole thing into a resolution. What would a resolution sound like? It's going to sound like this. Boss, kuch karna hai, SLES, that's it, kuch karna hai. If I was giving a batch lecture, I would probably say that would be a very wild old state. So, you know, there is no direction. With a resolution, there is no direction. So something interesting that I wrote in my notes says, it says, a commitment has a focus.
Yeah.
Whereas a resolution has an intention that puts you in tension and then makes you do nothing. It's a too bigger picture. Like here, you know, his goal is, he has a smart goal here, he has a smart goal here, he has a smart goal here. He's going step by step. So he knows that by the end of 2 years, iska result yahan se yahan lana hai. So what I'm trying to say is, rather than having a New Year resolution, you have commitments that you give first to yourself. Don't announce it. Let your work talk for it. I don't discuss my commitments until I have achieved my goals. And I do enjoy the journey a whole lot. I'm sure that when you go through this step by step, that you will enjoy this journey, that this will be worthwhile for you. And at the end of 2 years, which is what, 2021? 2022, we're going to see something very materialistic come out of this. So he has an end goal, but he also has broken it down into multiple goals. And when you break that commitment down into multiple goals, you will get there slowly yet very steadily. And this is something that we need to ponder about. So let's think about something that we can commit ourselves to this year. Since we are starting the year with this talk, perhaps we'll do like a review at the end of this year. Anyone wants to share what they think to be a resolution which I can help you change into a commitment? Is there a New Year resolution, Pranav? No? Huh? You don't believe in them. That's a good thing. I think we are all in the right place then. We're all in the right place. But let's look at anything at all that you think would be a great New Year's resolution. Live each day is not a resolution. That is a thought. Right? It is it is an idea or it is a philosophy of some sort,
so
that you know, carpe diem. Yeah, like a resolution. Like
yeah.
I was earlier, I was talking to them that you know, let's say I have a resolution. I'm going to lose 25 kilos this year. And how achievable is that as a resolution versus a commitment? So what do you think would be a good resolution that could be broken down to commitment? Now everybody wants to lose weight. Now that's a very common thing.
Resolution starts with weight, it's clear.
Resolution starts with weight, what do you mean?
I mean anything related to resolution if you think of,
yeah,
it's always related to weight.
Weight, like
yeah.
Motapa?
Huh. Huh.
Yeah, but that though we have already taken care of. Let's look at another big resolution that people make. Perhaps a person wants to become an entrepreneur. Okay, this year I will leave my job. So my best friend, he is a working professional in a corporate, and it's been I think 4 maybe 5 years that I've been trying to tell him that listen, I think it's time that you move towards spirituality. And all this while he's thought about resolutions. Okay, like you know, next saal karunga, next saal karunga, next saal ka mera resolution yeh rahega. What I helped him break it down into was commitment. So I said, you know what, can you commit to me that by the end of January you will have your first lesson plan for your first workshop that you will announce? And I gave him the topic also. So do you think that he might keep up to that?
Unless that detailed plan is there.
Hmm. So every day I check up with him.
Yes.
I'm a very good best friend to have, you know. I'm a coach by nature. So I push people till they don't have a choice but to do it.
Like whatever you do, but it should be a progress.
Exactly. So the way that we worked it out is, I took a commitment from him. I said, you know what, I'm your best friend and you're going to have to commit this to me. Okay, so he said, okay, fine, you know, I will follow what you say. So the way that we worked out was that by the end of this month, he's going to have a model of a workshop that he plans to teach. Then next month, we are going to start promotions around it. And then the next month, we are going to start to like advertise. So we will announce it to 2 months in advance. Then we will start the advertising. There will be a method. Now I have been doing this for many years. He has never done it. So of course I had to break him into it. But for that he needed to give me commitments. So first thing that we did was we mind mapped. I do like mind mapping. You know, it comes from my teacher in batch, and she is big on mind maps. And what helps us? This is something you might want to consider as well. So let's say, let's look at a goal that you guys could relate to. Any commitment that you can think of that you want to make to yourself? Or should we just take the generic health?
Yeah,
health, yeah? Okay. So this is our large topic, which could become this could be generalized into a resolution, no? But we are making it into a commitment. So what are the things that health comprises of?
In health,
yeah.
Since this is generic,
yeah.
We can take specific, like
exactly.
You can control, keep my diabetes under control.
Okay, so let's say diabetes, yeah.
So that the action will be specific.
Right. Now let's say if you are considering diabetes, how many things do you need to consider under diabetes? One would be diet.
Exercise.
The other would be exercise.
Stress.
Yeah, mental.
So there would be mental health, there would be perhaps even spiritual health, yeah? Now you have like, okay, so I want to be healthy. But what does being healthy mean to you?
Yeah.
Perhaps for him it means, you know, keeping my diabetes under control. And for that, these are my steps. But then I have to further break this down into bits and pieces.
Small.
Yeah. Steps. So now you see how a resolution just dissolves. Okay. Now this doesn't exist really, because health could mean a broad spectrum of things, right? So health has dissolved already, so New Year resolution to gaya gutter mein. But you came to something more specific. Oh yeah. So let's say that I'm talking about diet. What can I do about my diet which is smart, which is specific, measurable, achievable, realistic and time bound? What is possible which is smart? So let's just kind of make a little mental note here that it has to be smart. Okay. So in my diet, if I take like let's say 2 spoons of sugar in my morning tea, I could reduce it to 1 spoon of sugar.
Okay.
It's a smart goal. Okay, so 1 teaspoon less sugar. So you can check whether it is smart or not. Just one thing at a time, baby steps. Let's say exercise. Let's say if I don't work out at all, what am I going to do? Am I going to go bust my ass in the gym?
Yeah, at least walking. Start walking.
With like, okay, how much can I walk? If I have never walked, if I have always been the kind of a person who just sits and does nothing,
so
has a very sedentary life.
Short distance.
No, that would not be a smart goal.
Not smart.
A person who is completely inactive. Yeah. So I once had a friend who weighed 145 kilos, yeah, and the only thing that I got her into doing was like while she's sitting there, so we gave her one of those, what is it, Fitbit. So she put on that Fitbit and it would vibrate ever so often, and she had no choice but to stop it from vibrating, she had to walk for 10 minutes. So exercise starting once again with 10 minutes. 10 minutes only. Only 10 minutes, nothing more than that. And then you give yourself a 1 minute increment every week. Or every day. Not every week, rather, every day. So by the end of the first week, you've already given yourself 7 minutes up. Pehle din pe nahi, don't be harsh to yourself. Love yourself. It's all about self-love. Yeah? Then the mental health, what could you do which is smart for your mental health?
Breathing.
Breathing, yeah, but that's
breathing, meditation, all these.
If I want to feel better immediately, almost immediately, then what do I do?
Music
would be great. So for your emotional health, perhaps you listen to music once again for 10 minutes because you've never done it. Now this is a person who's never done anything for themselves. Yeah. And then for the spiritual health,
spiritual and yoga,
you could practice yoga, but people
technique also.
Yeah, so like for that, I think pranayam would be good. Once again, just 10 minutes of not even pranayam, but conscious breathing. You start here. So this is your starting point. Now when you make a schedule for your own self to do this, no, you will start reaping the benefits maybe after 3 months. But at least these are all smart goals, and you will start seeing the difference in your sugar levels just by doing something so little. You might think ke, you know, ek boond hai samundar ki. Samundar mein ek boond dalne se kuch nahi hota. But in Gujarati we say tipe tipe samundar bharai. like boon boon se samundar hota hai na, banta hai. If you keep on and on depleting yourself of everything, you will never fill up that sea for yourself. But if you keep putting in bit by bit, trickle by trickle, drop by drop, you will easily achieve it. And that is what a commitment will do versus a resolution. Yeah? So are we going to have a commitment then this year?
Yes.
Okay. Give me a big hands up if you are planning on a commitment. Oh, you give me a two hands up. I love that. I love that. I love that. So I look forward to hearing what your commitments are the next time that I'm back. Thank you so much for being a wonderful audience today, and wish you all a very happy new year.
Thank you.
Thank you.